Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, a station whereby we are going to learn and interact. We're going to have our mathematics form 1, lesson 1, whereby your tutor will be me, Mr. Gerald. We are going to handle the topic on decimals, but before that, we're going to have the following lesson objectives, whereby by the end of the lesson, you should be able to identify the place value of a given number. You should also be able to express fractions as decimals, and also you convert fractions to decimals. Let us start with the first round number. You are being required to identify the place values of decimals. For example, given the number 27.8005, the numbers on the left side, that is the left side, we are starting from 7. This one it will be on the 1s, while 2 is on the 10s. Then the numbers on the right after the decimal point will start from tens. So in our case, 8 is in the tens digit, while 0 is in the hundredths, and 5 is in the thousands. We can look at another number like 0.2587, whereby we have said the numbers on the left side of the decimal point, we are going to start with the ones, and the numbers on the right side of the decimal point, we start with tenths. So in our case, 2 is in the tenths digit, 5 is in the hundredths, 8 is in thousands, while 7 is in 10,000s. On our screen, you are required to express 3 over 4 as a decimal or 3 quarter as a decimal. What you normally do, you identify a common factor whereby you multiply both. So in our case, our common factor here is 25. So we are going to get 3, we multiply by 25, and also for the 4, we also multiply it with 25. So we are going to get 75 over 100, and then when we divide 75 divided by 100, we are going to get 0.75. So that is to mean 3 quarter as a decimal, we are going to get 0.75. On our screen, you are also required to express 1 over 8 as a decimal. And as I have said, you identify a common factor, whereby in our case, our common factor, we have taken 125. So you are going to take 1, you multiply with 125, and also 8, you multiply it with 125. So you are going to get 125 over 1000, and then when you are going to divide 125 over 1000, we are getting 0.125. So 1 over 8 as a decimal, we are getting it as 0.125. So basically, what you should do when you are given a fraction, you identify a common factor, then you multiply both the numerator and the denominator with the common factor. What we are now required to do, you should now, we are going to deal on the subtopic of recurring decimals, whereby this is where a group of numbers after the decimal repeat without ending. For example, you can have a number like 0.323232. So if you can see that 32 is repeating itself, so we can say 32 is recurring. Here you are required to express 1 over 3 as a decimal. So remember that the numerator is 1 and the denominator is 3. So let us now, we using the long division method, we are going to divide 1 divided by 3. And because 1 is not divisible by 3, we are going to add, put 0 above there, and we put 0 to the 1 for it to become 10. So at the end, we are going to have 0.33333, 3 is infinite. So we can say it is 0.3 recurring. Here, we are required to express 0.6. There is a dot above the 6. That is to mean, here the number is read as 0.6 recurring, and we are required to express it as a fraction. So that is to mean 0.666. So what we normally do, just put a point above the number that is recurring. So here you let R to be the recurring number. So in our case, it is 0.6666. We move on, we have 10R. So we are going to get 0.6 to multiply by 10, whereby you are going to get 6.666. You subtract the 2, that is 10R from R, and also the 6.66 recurring from 0.66. So at the end, you are going to get 9R to be equal to 6, whereby you divide both sides by 9, and your R, you are going to get 6 over 9. You divide further each by 3 to get 2 over 3. So 0.6 recurring as a fraction, you are getting as 2 over 3. Having done and said that, you are required to have the following activity, whereby you are required to express 0.73 recurring as a as a fraction. Remember, you have said that the point above the 3, it is to mean the 3 is recurring. So the number, our number on our screen is read as 0.73 recurring. So it is the one that you are required to express it as a fraction. Having done and said that, you can for more reference, you can refer to KLB, Secondary Mathematics Students Book 1, which is the 4th edition, Nairobi, Kenya Literature Bureau. And to get this mathematics lesson and many more, you can SMS us through the number that is on our screen, or you can subscribe to our YouTube channel, which is Elimu TV, or our Facebook page, which is also Elimu TV, or you can tweet us at Elimu TV _KE. Let us subscribe to all these channels so that we can get more of our enjoyable mathematics lessons. Thank you.